This is about a principal of Kendriya Vidyalaya in Bengaluru, Hebel, who has been booked for sexually harassing girls. The accused has was arrested, but now is out on bail. The charge against him is that he was harassing girl students. He was sending them lewd messages and personal messages via WhatsApp. Rohini, just tell us a little bit more about this case as well. Why has the principal been let out on bail? And give us an update on the investigations. Are the police questioning the staff or, you know, the students who have allegedly been victim to this kind of harassment?
Avantika, as we speak right now, I did get some messages from the Bangalore Police Commissioner clarifying that the principal has been arrested for verbal abuse of the students. Through the investigation, they have realized that there was no physical abuse or sexual abuse, but based on the complaint that Childline initially filed with the police, that was a complaint that is in the possession of India Today, where they talked about sexual abuse. But then after investigation, they realized that the students and the staff talked about verbal abuse as well as sending lewd messages through various social media groups. And that is why he was booked under Section 14 of POCSO, and that is a bailable section. And that is why he was taken into judicial custody. But the Bangalore police swung swiftly into action. They got into, as soon as they got the details from Childline, they not only interrogated the accused, but that is the principal, but also they also spoke to the staff and students and took their versions out. Initially, the investigation was indicating that they had to speak to the students, but now they have arrested him and let him out on bail. But the bigger point is that the Karnataka Child Protection Act covers only state government-run schools, but the Kendriya Vidyalaya falls under the central government. And so what happens is that largely it does not cover under the Karnataka Child Protection Act. And now the government agencies, especially the State Education Department, is looking at bringing the central schools on also under this purview, so okay. that if any case of abuse takes place, then they can also take
yes.
this action.
Now, absolutely, and that's the point I wanted to make, Rohini, that an abuse or in any kind is an abuse, if not physical, but even a verbal abuse can cause a lot of mental agony to a child, to a student.
Like young children at the in a school. And so it obviously is extremely traumatic. And the fact that it is happening not just to one or two of
right.
them, there have been several complaints. And that itself shows the fact that
okay.
action should have been taken. And why I tell you this is also because, according to the Karnataka Child Protection Act, anybody who has been accused or arrested for this particular POCSO Act should be suspended. He's not suspended but gone on long leave. So they should be able to amend the Act soon after to bring this under the purview.
All right, Rohini, thank you so much for joining us and getting us up to speed with all the updates on both those cases. The investigation still presently underway.